Hello again, rail fans and model railroaders. Welcome back to another video. Today's date is April 3rd, 2022, and we are located at one of the most well-known model train displays in the state of Ohio, Entertrainment Junction. The reason why I was down here was because a friend of mine, Trilight Productions, invited me to go on a behind-the-scenes tour with him here at Entertrainment Junction. However, before we get our visit started, let's get some historical context out of the way first. Entertrainment Junction opened for business on August 1st, 2008, in a small town called Westchester, which is a suburb that's in between Dayton and Cincinnati. The building that Entertrainment Junction is located in is 25,000 square feet, and it mainly uses G-scale model trains. On a regular basis, you can see 90 G-scale model trains running about the layouts from three different time periods: the early days, the transition era, and the modern era. In addition to the model train displays, there are also other amenities the place has to offer as well, like a cafe to have a nice meal while you're here, a couple playgrounds, and a train ride for the kids, as well as a hobby store for model railroaders like myself. Now, that was just a brief and oversimplified history of Entertrainment Junction, but if you want to learn more, you can go to their website, which will be listed at the end of the video. One more thing before we get started, I would like to point out that I have been here before. However, that was many years ago, back in 2017, before I started this YouTube channel, so this is the first time Entertrainment Junction is featured on this channel. Anyways, kick your shoes off, grab some popcorn, and a drink of your choice, and without further ado, let's get started because there's a lot we need to cover.
You could see the people walking through with the reflection of the plexiglass, but there's nothing I can really do about it. But I can still see the trains though.
Right. Straight behind you.
Only two cars on this one.
Yeah. Local.
Yeah.
Here comes the mine train. That is some very neat hopper cars.
So.
Thank you. go. Let's head up in the very top.
It's gone back inside.
Colin Crescent's coming.
Whoa! There's a tender for a locomotive.
Yeah, there's a plow over there as well.
to the train line. Was they did another 600 or 700 lines of writing code to make a tablet talk to the computer. And so now they can go out and they have a really nice graphic display of the throttles, which train, and there's even a schematic of the actual track on that page. And they can grab that train and control it, move it forward and back at every stage when they need to. So that's made that nice. Not to mention, if these fail, we just buy more from Ranger while they go to a cheap place of Ranger. The overheard sound was a kid screaming wild terror because his parents were trying to leave. And, you know, he can see Thomas still going around on that kiosk. It's a good call. It's kind of gratifying to see two multiple generations of people come in and they can all kind of share this common interest. That's been kind of a fun part of it. Although, typically, if there are three generations, you see the grandkids and grandparents of the conversion over to the PLC system. Yeah. So, it's just the train state, so it shows each line. And then each train, so the letters designate which train it is on that line.
Yeah.
To different areas. So we have some really slow days here where there might not be anybody walking through a section of the layout for 10 or 20 minutes. And since we had already been kind of dealing with the wear and tear issue, you know,
these trains are running 8 hours a day,
363 days a year. So they bought some stainless steel rail. Started replacing it and threading it into the existing ties.
You should have got a G scale model of one of the war I'm tracking rule trains.
Oh, I've seen a video of that.
You should have gotten a model of that.
Well, they actually wore down the rails so much that profile of the track turned into a piece of brass wire.
So you really needed a drive geometry train.
Guess what happened after they put stainless steel rails in? Like how I used to come by the GM.
There's that Southern Passenger train that you were talking about. Those people up there must be awesome.
Have you ever been to Natural Bridge in Kentucky?
I think so.
That's an actual model of a rock formation down in eastern central Kentucky. It's pretty popular around here. And Red River Gorge, if you've ever heard of that, it's real nearby. Popular hiking.
And there you have it, folks. That was our visit. Although, before we go, there's a couple things I would like to discuss here real quick. First and foremost is what you're looking at on the screen right now, which was a purchase that I made at the hobby shop. Specifically, a Walther's Mainline HO Scale Amtrak material handling car. It's nicely detailed considering it's a budget-friendly model, it rolls really good, there's basically not much, if anything, to complain about it. If you want to visit Entertrainment Junction yourself, they are located at 7379 Square Court, West Chester Township, Ohio. They are open to the public on a regular basis between 12 o'clock p.m. and 6 o'clock p.m. For more information as well as tickets, you can visit their website at https://www.entertrainmentjunction.com. Anyways, leave a like and or a comment down below to share your thoughts on the video. If you enjoy the content that I make, consider subscribing to my YouTube channel and tapping the bell button to be notified when a new video gets posted. That's all for now. This is All Ohio Rail Fan, signing off.